Hey everyone, this is Ken, and we are back with part two of the digital clock. So we're going to start off exactly where we left off at, and we're going to add some blocks right here in section one. So place some blocks there right in front of each repeater and each redstone dust. Now the best method is to really just put it straight across just like so, and delete the ones in between. See? And you want to create this kind of checkered kind of pattern, which is basically, like I said, a block in between or in front of the redstone dust and repeaters. Perfect. Add some blocks straight across, delete the ones in between. And we're going to do it to each one. Now at this point, guys, we're going to start creating the display panel, which is great. Now keep in mind, guys, this does get very repetitive at this point. The cool thing is we're also going to get into the coding of the system and the AM and FM settings as well. Now once you get to the end over here, I just want you to place two blocks just like so. And that's pretty much it for the end section. Now, go straight to the center, to that block right over here in the middle, and you're going to place one redstone torch in front of each one. Then you're going to go right underneath and place two blocks going straight down. And on the second block, you're going to place a half slab on the top part. Then you're going to delete the two blocks. Now you're going to repeat the same exact process to each one. So place the two blocks there with the half slab and delete the two blocks that we just placed. And just do that one more time. Now once you've done that, you're going to extend those half slabs one more block forward. And of course, you're going to do that to each one. Which is great. Now right there, you're going to place some redstone dust with a repeater going forward. See? Because what you really want is that redstone torch to activate that repeater at one point. Now right here in the first section, you're going to place a block there and a piston going forward. So you're going to place three sticky pistons in the front there. Now in this part, you're going to delete that block and place a block on the top and one on each side. Then you're going to place a block on that top part one more time. And place some redstone dust right on top of each one. Now the reason this is set up that way is for the simple fact that you don't want the redstone dust to activate the piston underneath it, because that's the timing system. Now with the other two, it's a little simple. Just place three blocks right across with some sticky pistons in front of it and some redstone dust right on top of it. You see? But it's only that first part where it gets a little different. Then delete those two, place some blocks across with some sticky pistons, and one more time, some redstone dust right across. Now, what I like to do once I'm done completing each little segment here, we're going to cover it up with some blocks of your choice. Perfect. Now, at this point, place a block right there and a sticky piston on the side, and what we're going to do is create the letter 8 or the number 8 shape all around. So place some blocks right there, some sticky pistons right across just like so, and of course three on the side, or on each side, and three on top. Perfect. Now you're going to do that to each one. So the first three should look just like this at this point. And once you've done that, you should notice that there's a 5-block gap in between each section. Now what you want to do is place 5 blocks on the side over here, parallel to that side column, and place 3 sticky pistons. Place a block on top and 3 more sticky pistons going upwards. You could delete that because that was just temporary. And that's going to create the hours of the clock itself. Now let's start connecting all the pieces together. Now, What you want to do is place a torch right over here on this top block. And there as well. Then you'll place a block on top of that. And pretty much place a block on top of each torch, guys. And delete that. We're going to place a block on top of this torch as well. And we're going to place three blocks in the centerpiece, because we're going to activate that. You're going to have some redstone dust on top. Place a block right there with a half slab underneath. Delete that. And place one repeater going forward on the inside. And there you have it, guys. The centerpiece is ready to be used. Now, we're going to do this one more time to each other. Well, of course, to the other segments. Place a repeater there, some blocks right across with some redstone dust in a straight line. I'll place a block there and there. Half slab right underneath the center. Delete that. A repeater going towards the block. Add two more blocks on the side with some redstone dust on top. Now, once it's all done, what I want you to do is go to the front panel and add your block of choice in the centerpiece. Okay? Which to me is a great way to indicate that you just completed that center section. Now we're going to start working on the bottom side pieces. Now you're going to place a block there, and on the side, delete the first one. Then you can place one torch in front of that block. Now that's going to activate all the pistons, which is perfect. Now all you have to do is place a block right there on that bottom piece. Two half slabs, delete the first one. And add one piece of redstone dust. That's going to retract the entire piston, guys. Now place two blocks right across. Delete that one. Place a torch right underneath it. You're then going to place a block right there with a half slab right underneath. You're going to delete the first one and place some redstone dust right on top. Then, of course, we're going to cover the front part up to let us know that we already just completed that. And then, once again, we're going to repeat the same exact process to each one. So, delete that. Add a torch in front of it. A block right there with a half slab underneath. Delete the block and put some redstone dust right on top. And you pretty much get the gist at this point. Delete that, of course. Place a torch in front of it, a block there, a half slab underneath, and delete that as well. With some redstone dust right on top. And of course, you're going to cover that up. And you're going to do it one more time for the center section, well, the third section at this point. And guys, like I said, this is a very repetitive process. And the cool thing is, we actually do this to the last section as well. Which is section 4, which is going to be the hours at this point. And the cool thing is, you really don't need a lot of redstone dust to activate each piece here, as you notice. Block there, a half slab underneath, some redstone dust on top, and you're pretty much good to go. Look at that. It really didn't take that much time, to be honest. So once you get over here, once again, we just repeat the same format we did with the other sections, okay? Torch there. To get the extension, place the block there with a half slab underneath. Delete the block on top and just add the redstone dust right on top of it. Then, of course, we're going to add some blocks of your choice in front of it. Now we're going to start working on the top part. So place some blocks right across with some redstone dust on top of it. Place a block there with a half slab underneath. Delete that. Now I want you to go right over here to the side piece. You see this block right there on the left? See, right there on the left side, more towards the center. Place a torch on the side of it with a block on top. And what I want you to do is place one more block on top of it with a half slab on the side of it. Block on top of that, half slab on the side of that. and a block on top, and you're going to connect it to that half slab on the top part, and you're going to delete the blocks in between. Now you're going to place some redstone dust on top of those half slabs until you get to this point. Place a repeater there, and then the rest of the redstone dust behind it. And that section will activate the top part of it. Now one more time, right here on that block, see where the center is at? On the left side, place a torch on the side of that block, and a block on top of that torch. Then you'll place a block on top of that with a half slab on the side of it. You're going to delete that. Block on top of that with a half slab on the opposite side. Delete the first block. A block on top of that with a half slab right there. You're going to delete that, and you should just have like three half slabs, then place one half slab going forward and add some redstone dust from that point. And there, and one more time. Fantastic. Then a repeater going forward with three blocks behind the piston with some redstone dust across. Now, once again, guys, we're going to try this one more time. Place a torch on the side of that block with a block on top of that torch. Then a block pretty much right more on top of that block with a half slab on the side. Delete the first one. Block on top. Half slab on the other side. Delete that. Block on top. Then a half slab right there. And you're going to delete that. And at this point, place your redstone dust going upwards. Then a half slab right there with a repeater going forward and three blocks right in front of it with some redstone dust on top. Alright, so we pretty much got the top section off, and now at this point we're going to start focusing on the side panels. Let's cover that up to let us know we just finished completing that. Now we're going to go straight to the back part here. And we're going to add two blocks like so, delete that, place a half slab, well, a redstone torch underneath that block. Three blocks going forward, place a half slab there, delete that. Now at this point, you're going to place some redstone dust right there, and this is where it gets a little tricky, alright guys? Place a torch right here on this block, but you're going to place it on the side of it, going inwards. With a block on top, and a torch on top of it. See? Now once we get to the other side, you're going to place a torch on the side of the block going inwards, a block on top, torch on top, a block right on top of it. Then you're going to place some blocks going forward, a block right there. Then you're going to place a half slab right there and delete the first one. Then add a torch right there to activate all the pistons, and then you're going to put some redstone dust behind it to, of course, turn it off. Then once you're done, you're going to cover all that up. Alright, now we're going to go to section 2 here and repeat the same process. So place a torch on the side of that block with a block on top. A torch on top of it with a block right on top of that. Then add two more blocks, then one on the top sticky piston. Place a torch right underneath right there. Then you're going to place a half slab underneath the center block. Delete the block on top and add some redstone dust on top of it. There you have it, guys. So we're going to cover that up with some blocks of our choice. Now let's go back to the other side as well. And repeat this one more time. So, some torches right there, a block on top. Delete that in the center. Place a torch there. Add two more blocks. A block on top of the top sticky piston with a torch behind it in front of that block. Then a half slab right there. You're going to delete the block on top of it and add some redstone dust to deactivate that torch. Now right here is going to be a bit simple, okay? So add a torch right on the side of that block with a block on top of it, with a torch on top of that, with a block right there. Add two more blocks going forward, a block on top with a torch underneath to activate it. And right here, you're going to place your half slab and make sure you put that redstone dust on top of it. Whew, all right. Now, we're going to cover that up, and at this point, I want you to go about 1, 2, 3. And on the fourth one, we're going to delete that and put a little block there as a mark indicator. Now, the reason I have that there is we're going to place a dropper going forward, a dropper on top going upwards from that point, and a dropper going the opposite direction with a hopper going downwards. Then you're going to place one dirt inside the dropper. Now, the reason for that is because that's going to be the system that's going to activate the AM and PM clock. So you're going to place two comparators with repeaters just like so. You should have this kind of layout. Now right there, you're going to place a half slab with a repeater going forward and, of course, a sticky piston going outwards with a redstone block in front of it. Then place two blocks going outwards. Delete the first one. Place a block right there. Delete that. Add it right there. And I want you to place a torch in front of that block. And a repeater in front of that. And some redstone dust right across on the top part. Then you're going to place a block in front of that with a torch going forward. Now from this point in front, you're going to place some redstone dust right across until you reach that redstone torch. Now this does get a little tricky, you guys. Now, we have to place a repeater there with a block there. And the reason for that is in the section, well, in the third section, right in the middle, you're going to place a half slab and a repeater going outwards. A block in front of it, a block right there, delete that, and add some redstone dust on top of it. Now you're going to add a sticky piston underneath with some redstone blocks right there from that point, and you're going to add some blocks parallel to that redstone block. See? So delete that. And that's what's going to activate that redstone dust to really set up the 12 o'clock setting mode. So what you're going to do is place some blocks like so and extend the redstone dust going forward. Then you're going to place another block right there, add some redstone dust, and you're going to extend that from this point all the way down to that block right over here. And that's going to be exactly 15 blocks long. Now from this point, guys, we're going to go right here, one block inwards, place a block right there in that corner, and place a sticky piston going forward. You see? Delete that. And we're going to place four sticky pistons going upwards, just like so. Four in total. Then two more, just like that. And we're pretty much creating the letter A. You see? Then you're going to go one more outwards, just like so, one block away. And we're going to create the M. So go four up, one on the side, one in the center. One more time on the side, and four more straight up, just like so. So two right there, and two more underneath. Perfect. All right. So we got the AM set up. Now we got to do the PM. Now for the PM, you're going to place two blocks like so, delete the button underneath, and you're going to create the same exact letter like the A, but you're going to delete that bottom part. That's pretty much it. Then you're going to leave a one block gap in between the PM and AM, and of course you're going to repeat the M as well. Place a sticky piston right there, and two right underneath, and one more on top. Now we got to pretty much connect the entire system. So at this point, place a block right there on the second row, and stretch it right across. And you're going to do that one more time on top as well, okay? But before we do that, let's add some torches to activate the pistons right across, you see? Now place some torches right there. And what you want it to do is delete any excess torches that aren't doing anything. Then right there, leave a block, delete that. Put some blocks right across with a space in between, just like that. And of course, you're going to add some torches in front to activate the pistons. See? Add one there, one next to it. Leave a space in between and one right there. And you should have a full extension at this point. Now, one more time, we're going to repeat the same exact process right on top. Go right there in the center. Add some torches in front to get a full piston extension. And once you've done that, delete that. Put another row of blocks right on top for the top part. And guys, it just gets very repetitive at this point. You're then going to repeat the same exact process to make sure that all the pistons get activated. So always double check that. Fantastic. Now, to connect the entire system, we have to do an invert signal, which I'll get to that in a bit. So add two blocks there, a torch right there, a block there with a half slab right on the side. Now all you're going to do is add some redstone dust right across. Add some right on top and on that half slab as well. You see? So that when it goes off, it all turns off at the same exact time. And you're going to add a block there, a torch on top, block there, torch on top, block there, torch on top, block there. And of course, you're pretty much doing four blocks going upwards. Now, I just realized we just got to delete those two blocks and put the comparator, or repeater there, a block there, and the comparator on the back part of it. Like I said, we have to invert the signal. Perfect. Now, once you've done that, you're going to place a half slab right there, a block there, and a half slab just like so, right there on the side of it. And delete that. And all you have to do, guys, is add some redstone dust right on top so that the entire system, or just the AM or PM part, I mean, could turn off in perfect sequence. And just make sure you add some redstone dust on that half slab. Now, to manually control this, you're going to put a repeater there, a block there, and some redstone dust in a straight line from this point. Delete that. Delete that. And of course, that's where you're going to place your button. And if you guys ever want to change it manually, you can do that as well. All right, so let's test it out. Once you hit the button, you're going to notice they're going to move smoothly. Look at that. Now at this point, guys, pause the video and kind of cover up the entire section. Now, when I mean section, this is what I mean as far as section. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4, and these are all the sections. Now they're going to be very important from this point, especially when it comes to coding. Now, when I mean code, that means that each one of these strips, as you see, is considered one code, okay? Now, pause at this point, because you're gonna need this setup to program your system, either in Minecraft time or real time. Now, make sure you pause this and read the directions in front of it, because this is very important, guys. Otherwise, you could really mess this up. Now, these are the number program format for the codes itself, because you have to take out certain blocks so that the display could show that exact number. So feel free to pause at that point as well and just get all your information together before we start programming. Now at this point, I'm going to show you how to do the Minecraft time, okay? Now we're going to place a glass block right here on the second part, well, the third part really. And right over here is going to be the inverse signal. So you're going to delete that and place a solid block, because that's going to activate the section next to us. Now, in the program sheet, that's going to be the red numbers that I showed you on that picture, okay? So, when I mean to activate the section next to it, that's what I mean as far as that. So, you guys don't get too confused. Now, once you set the number up, you're going to press the button in the front, and you're going to go back on top of here. And right here in this top section off, we're going to create the next number. Now, we just did 0. Now the next one is going to be 3. See? Perfect. Now, at this point, guys, the next number we're going to create or input is the number 6. We're going to delete that top corner right there. And if you check in the front, it's going to be 6. Now, I'm going to show you how to program this in particular, especially the first section. Now, the next number we're going to create is 9. So, all you have to do is delete that block right there and place one glass in front of it. See? And once you check the front panel, that should be number 9. Now, the next number we're going to create is number 2. So you want to delete that block as well. Place a glass piece right there and go right over here to the second one and place a glass block right there as well. Now this number 2 is going to be the number that's going to activate the system next to it. So you want to go right here in the back part and place a block right there to activate the system next to us. So that every time 2 comes up, it activates the number next. Well, then the section right next to it. So let's go to the next number. The next number will be number 5. And we're going to set that up as well. So for number 5, you're going to delete this block right there. Place a glass block in front. And delete the one at the end. Place a glass block right there. Now let's hit the button right in the front one more time. And that's going to be number 8. So we leave that alone. We hit it one more time again. Now once you hit it, when you go straight to the back, and as you notice, this top section right here hasn't been touched because that's number 8. Now all you have to do for number 1 is delete 5 blocks right across and replace it with glass. And because number 1 is going to be a signal that's going to activate the system next to it, you're going to delete that block and place one solid block inside to, of course, activate the section next to it. So let's check out the front piece. And that's number 1. And we got 2 more numbers to go to, okay, guys? Now, we got to put number 4 at this point. I'm going to delete pretty much those blocks right in the center, just like so, and replace it with glass. And of course, the next number is going to be number 7, and then the first section is complete. Now guys, go back, if you get a chance, to the programming picture I showed you, and the number programming setup I showed you as well. Because that's going to really help you as far as programming these numbers easily, without having to go back and forth and just double check what you're doing so many times. Because trust me guys, that is a hassle. So if you get a chance, just go back to those pictures, probably take a picture of it, screenshot it, so that once you're doing this, it's easier to set up and it's, you know, it makes the whole process a lot easier. Okay? So I did the first section for you, but at this point, I want you guys to really set the whole thing up from that point on. Because the first section is what really makes a difference as far as setting up the whole thing. Now, this last section here gets a little different, okay? Section 4 is a bit complicated, but simple at the same time. Because what you're going to do is place a block on every other section. See? So it's pretty much going to be all glass on one side, see? And all blocks on the next one. So make that all blocks straight across, and in this section is going to be all glass. And this part will be all blocks. Then over here will also be all glass. And of course, once again, all solid blocks. Now the reason this is set up that way is so that the one and the blank of the number comes back and forth every time it rotates. Make sure you do it right, otherwise you can mess this up. As you can see right in front of us, I actually did mess up. Gonna replace that with glass, and of course back here, make sure that is a solid block. So delete those 2 pieces of glass right there and add some blocks. and it's pretty much a back and forth pattern in the last section, okay? So it has to be glass, block, glass, blocks, glass, and blocks. So that's pretty much the program setup for that last section. So it's really not too complicated. Now at this point, guys, the system is pretty much complete at this point. Now we're just going to test it out and see if everything's going to run smoothly. And all you have to do is go to this corner right here and just activate that button. Now guys, the reason Minecraft time, the numbers are different, they're not consistent as 1 straight to 9, is because of the time difference. So you have to chop it up a certain way to really get that perfect flow to it. Now guys, this is an extra security feature that you can add to the system itself. Now you need to put an unmovable block, for example obsidian, on these certain corners, because that piston is going to push this code forward. You want to place a block right there, and this piston on top is going to push this code downwards. So you want to put a block right under here as well. Now the reason you want to put these blocks there is because sometimes the system, or the system you're playing on, might be lagging so much that it actually might push out one of the codes, for the simple fact that a piston didn't even get a chance to really activate the way it should have activated. Now guys, you don't need to use obsidian, you can also use a furnace, which is a lot easier to make. But you can only do this at the end of it, okay? So what you want to do, if you want to do it, is just place some furnaces right across on top of these three specific sections. Now they reduce the risk of any of the codes being pushed out due to any kind of lag, or your system freezing up for whatever reason. Maybe you have too much redstone, or you're playing on a server, whatever the case may be. Now you don't have to put it on, it'll still work perfectly fine, but I like to add that just to give me that extra security, or to pretty much prevent anything from being pushed out for whatever reason. Now guys, the build is complete. Hey, I want to thank everybody for watching. If you could please leave a comment and subscribe. Thank you.